What a fabulous day. Let's see what's happening on Out Late But Great. Logging on. Cool. A new video.
Welcome to Monday with Michelle on Out Late But Great. Hope you guys are having a good day so far and hope you all had a great weekend. My weekend was very full. This past weekend was the last two concerts of the season. And now I will have no more concerts until fall, so it's going to be nice to have a little bit of a break from rehearsals and crazy schedule and everything that happens around this time of year. This week, Jim from Georgia set our topic, and he says, "Do you have family members or close friends who are still in the closet about who you are? In other words, do they accept the fact that you're gay, lesbian, or transgender, yet not want their friends, neighbors, or coworkers to know about it? If so, how do you feel about that? And what advice would you offer all the people involved?" Okay, well, having to look at my own situation first, since that's the one I know best, at this point, I don't think there's anybody in my family that is ashamed or embarrassed about who I am. And I have to say that for my mom and dad, this is funny because they do accept me and Kirsten, and obviously we just had this huge wedding and everything. Well, not huge, but decent sized wedding. I've been around several of their friends since I've been out, and Kirsten's been with me. And no one's ever, seemed like they were weirded out by it or anything like that. But I don't know how many people in her circle of friends know, but knowing my mother and how outspoken and social that she is, I can't imagine that she would have kept that to herself. So I don't think that she is in the closet on my behalf about me. I really don't think so. And we have other gay people in our family, so it's not like I'm the only one, which I'm really grateful for. So no, I don't think that I have any family members or close friends. And the people that are close to me, they couldn't be in the closet about me if they tried. Because if the people on my Facebook know, it's just right out there who I'm married to. And everybody at my work knows. I mean, Kirsten was just with me at our reception after both concerts that I did on the weekend. And I don't think anybody is wondering about me anymore. I've pretty much put myself out there. And in fact, when I started this channel too, I really took chance because I knew that it was going to be kind of beyond my control at some point. And that's fine. That's fine. The outer, the better, as far as I'm concerned. Okay, but if I were to know anybody that has family that's staying in the closet because they're ashamed, the first thing that I think I would advise is for the person who is out, or whoever the person is in the LGBTQ community, I would advise them to sit down with their family member or friend and have a discussion about why that person feels shame. And when I really thought about this topic, the only emotion that I could come up with that would keep somebody in the closet about their son or daughter or friend would be shame, that they were ashamed of how they turned out. And I think if the person has a discussion with that member of the family or friend about the fact that we were just born this way and we're as normal as anyone else, people are just programmed to believe otherwise. And also, if that person were to, that person being the member of the LGBTQ community, were to really explain to their family member or their friend how difficult it is to stay in the closet, and that they feel so much more relieved now that they're not in the closet, and that they really need that person's support in order to help them feel that their life is really no big deal compared to anyone else's. And that we really should not be treated any differently for any reason. When I very first came out to my parents, okay, this is 2.5 years ago, one of the first things after it kind of simmered down a little bit was my mom said, "Well, you're not going to tell anybody, are you?" And at that time, when it was so fresh and I was really quite fragile about all of this, my answer to her was kind of cloudy, because I had no idea that I would be as outspoken and as much of an activist as I am today, even 2.5 years ago. I was a strong advocate for gay rights when it was about other people. But as soon as I had to face my own reality, I wasn't sure how out I could be in my own life because of my job and being the fact that it's related to a church and such. But I'm happy to report that that has all been fine. But I do remember my mom asking me if I was going to tell anybody else. And then periodically, like shortly after that, she would say, "Well, you know, who knows? So I know who knows." Because she had friends who kind of knew some of the people that I worked with. And eventually, it was just out there. So it was good. So anybody that's going through that, my heart goes out to you. Because I can imagine how difficult it is to go through all the pain of coming out and then having your close family or friends pretend that it's something otherwise. So they just have to realize that there is no shame involved, no shame whatsoever. And in fact, if you need a good book, Kirsten let me borrow this book originally, and it's called Coming Out of Shame. And that might be a good book that you might want to pass along to somebody in a family situation or a friend. Okay, well, thank you for the topic, Jim. I wish it could have been a little bit more profound about my answer, but I hope that you all have a fantastic week. And as always, please leave your thoughts. Peace.